Oh boy, what a topic for me. So, as a child, my mother like drowned us in affection, especially me because I was the youngest of five. So, by no means was she a pushover though. She was actually the disciplinarian in my household. But when it came to, loving her children and showing them affection, my mother just filled us overboard with it. So, what this did was it created a very big capacity for love and affection in me. So when I started dating, which was way too early, I looked to receive that same love and affection my mother gave me from women. The problem was the kind of women I was attracted to, very provocative, seductive, kind of girls. So I would look for this love and affection in the kind of women who could never really give it to me because they had never really received it for themselves. I was basically looking for good girl qualities in bad girls. I know that's a very, vague description, but I think, you get the idea. James 1:18 says this: "A double-minded man is unstable in all of his ways." I wanted something, but was looking for it where it couldn't be found. And I feel like, that can be a case with a lot of us just in different aspects of our life. Needless to say, I was disappointed over and over and over again, never realizing that the problem was internal. And because I loved really, really hard, when I got hurt really, really badly. Like abnormal heartbreak, like traumatizing kind of pain is what I went through and felt. Now, don't get me wrong, I was far from faithful myself. I've explained in previous videos, I was basically a sex addict. But yeah, that didn't exclude me from becoming severely heartbroken, we use the word soulmate as a title for our physical companion. And that may be our life partner, but it's not our soulmate. The actual legitimate mate of our soul is the Holy Spirit of God. It's actually the other part of our soul that perfectly fulfills it and completes it. Isaiah 54:5 says this: "For your maker is your husband. The Lord of hosts is his name." This is what I was actually looking for and what everybody is actually looking for, just in different ways, whether or not they know that. Psalm 16:11 says this: "You make known to me the path of life. In your presence there is fullness of joy. At your right hand there are pleasures forevermore." Amen.